Alright, hello and welcome everyone here to the Join Dota League Season 3. We're in Europe Division 2. We've got a two-game series here between Central of Fear going up against the Northern Lions. I was a little slow on figuring out the password, so I am just spectating from Dota TV, so the stream is going to have a total of 4-minute delay, as if you're watching a game, it'll just be 2 minutes. We'll remedy that as Game 2 approaches, but first we got to get through the draft of Game 1 and Game 1 itself. And of course, I'm Helium. I'll be covering this for you this evening or this afternoon, depending on where you reside. But the bans in the pick, Central of Fear, they've got three. They've got Doom, Skywrath, Mage, and the Death Prophet. So a bit of push, well, a lot of push in the Death Prophet. A bit of push in the Doom, I think, is pretty good. Bringing those auras into the push really helps. And a lot of burst damage and not really a lot of lockdown, but a really long range slow with which to initiate on the Skywrath Mage at their bans. We've got the Tidehunter taken out. Razor has been taken out, Enigma, and Ancient Apparition. So a lot of those really big teamfight heroes and teamfight control heroes, especially the Ravage, the Black Hole, and of course pushing into Ancient Apparition Ice Blast is never fun. And if you fail to kill a Razor who's taken all of your right-click damage and he's got his Eye of the Storm up, well, life can get pretty hard. So taking out those heroes over at the Northern Lions, they first picked a Tinker and a Wraith King. So Tinker should be the mid hero, Wraith King a little more ambiguous, could be a support, could be a carry, and then of course Morana, pretty much the same thing, could be offlaner, support, carry, we don't really know. And I kind of like Northern Lions draft for that. Also Tinker gonna help stop the push, so that'll be really beneficial to them as long as he doesn't get shut down. And looking over at their bans, they've taken out a Brewmaster and a Viper, which are really, really strong mid heroes right now. Viper obviously building into a mech. Brew probably goes blink, and then phase mana into an Ags. But either way, really strong laning opponents that could maybe actually stop Tinker, and then taking out the Void and the Pugna. Pugna probably because they're scared of more push. They don't want to have Tinker having to go up against the Nether Ward of Pugna, and obviously Chronosphere is Chronosphere, so you never really want to have to deal with that. And now that we're caught up, looking over to the fourth pick, Central of Fear, they're going to need one more support, and they're probably going to need an offlaner. So as for a support, when you're going up against Tinker, I don't know. I don't really know what you want to do. Personally, I think Juggernaut is a really interesting either potential offlaner or support against Tinker, just because the Healing Ward really is so good. Later in the game, you can actually just walk through Tinker's March as a team if the Healing Ward is up, and you pretty much sustain, not really taking any damage. But running Juggernaut support is not the easiest thing. We've obviously saw a couple of the top tier teams do it, mainly DK, Lanham on his Juggernaut. It is a thing. I don't think Central of Fear will pick it, but I think it's pretty good. Also, that Healing Ward would help with the push, but they will go with the Slark, maybe to deal with the Wraith King, thinking he's a core. Slark does do very well against other melee cores. He also does very well against Batrider, actually. You cannot Firefly away or leap away, so it does well against the Morana out of that Pounce Leash that Slark can provide, so that's going to be pretty dangerous. Good hero pickup, I think. It doesn't really lend itself much to the push, a little bit to split push. And it is a hero that probably will build Shadowblade, so it can definitely jump the Tinker, potentially the Morana. Really, it can jump anybody, but you're really looking to catch the Tinker out so that it can't keep pushing out the lanes and get a ton of farming experience. So Slark, I think, a pretty good pickup for that. And again, if he gets out of control, super hard to deal with. Even a gem, True Sight, Dust, whatever, won't reveal him in his ultimate. So he can really kill the supports if they fall behind. And I'm thinking maybe even go Diffuse. I think Mana Drain against Wraith King is really, really strong. So if he goes Diffusal and starts taking away Wraith King's mana so that he can't even get his Reincarnate, and that basically makes that hero useless. Because he's really only picked up. Sure, his stun got buffed pretty hard. His auras are good. The crit adds some random KSs to your team, but it's really the Reincarnate that you want to have on your team. You initiate with the Wraith King, he dies. That slow, that minus attack speed slow, it's insane. And then the rest of the team is going to come in, the Batrider, the Morana, and the Tinker. Although Tinker doesn't really have any ability to just come into the team fight, they're going to build a Necro maybe on somebody. There's no really Necro holder yet, but anyone with summonable units or a Necro book, something like that, is really, really good. And they're actually going to go Bloodseeker to try to counter the Slark as the last pick there. And Central of Fear are going to go with Abaddon. I guess, I mean, Abaddon is probably the best hero to have when going up against the Batrider Lasso, as well as the 5-second arrows from Mirana. Also, the missed chance from Tinker's Laser, Wraith King, his stun. Abaddon can get people out of everything. He'll even get you out of Rupture to chase down. So, Bloodseeker to counter the Slark, but Abaddon does well against all of their heroes. Unfortunately, Abaddon Skywrath, they've got a bit of burst between each other, but they don't have any lockdown. Just the slow from Sky. And they're not really going to be able to be roaming supports in the early game. So it's going to have to be Doom and Death Prophet and Slark winning their lanes and not really needing help. That way Abaddon and Skywrath can find their levels and maybe, you know, rotate. They can get kills, of course. It's just not super easy. If they're always off the map, though, in the jungle, and then they just show up in a lane, it could lead to a kill. Not too hard with the Slark pounce. Because Slark does have some disables. So if they rotate to his lane, it won't be as hard to find those kills. And we'll see if any of that comes true this game, as we're going to get started here. That's a beautiful tower there in the middle lane, but we're going to actually go ahead and introduce the teams right now. Over on the side of Central of Fear on the Dire, we've got Get Wrecked, apparently a stand-in, I'm not really sure. Don't know too much about either of these teams, but I hope to learn about them. We've got Get Wrecked playing the Slark. Supporting up here, it's going to be the Mac Club on the Skywrath Mage. Abaddon's going to be handled by Daywalker. And Noctis on the Death Prophet here in the mid lane. And off lane, it will be a Doom, just devouring up those creep. He goes boots first as to escape the stun from the Wraithfire Blast. And it is a support Wraith King. And to introduce the Northern Lions, we'll start there with the Wraith King. It's going to be Jean playing that. Ingman on the Bloodseeker that will be farming in this lane. And Regulus on the support, roaming Mirana. That's a really, really strong roaming combination, this Wraith King and this Mirana. And we'll see what they can get done with that. Nice ward here, though. Oh, I'm some Dota TV I can't draw. Really nice ward here from the Dire, scouting that out. So that will make Doom's offlane maybe not easy, but definitely safe. And then Phantom XP mid lane on the Tinker here for the Northern Lions. And up north, it's going to be CA California. I'm not really sure. They're European, so I doubt that's what that stands for. But it's going to be CA playing on the Batrider offlane, also opting to go boots first, pulled over two tangles while buying four of his own, looking at Doom about the same, bought his own set of tangles, got pulled one, has a clarity, and the mid lane matchup, it will be Death Prophet versus Tinker. I guess something we pretty much could have assumed. You don't really put Death Prophet in too many other places besides the mid lane. Occasionally in safe lane, maybe with one support, or just by yourself if you know the lanes from your enemy team. She's going to look to probably get a quick Yules. Maybe a mech? Doom is probably going to go for the mech here in the offlane. Just with the Devour, it's pretty good gold. He's going to look for a big creep now. Not really the one you want, but he'll take it for now. Ooh, the Alpha Wolf would have been much better to go ahead and pick up first, as this gives you nothing. It gives you Thunderclap, which is kind of nice, but also kind of useless. And he just spams out his mana just to feel good about himself, picking up that regen rune. So Ingman will be farming pretty much uncontested down here in the bottom lane, and honestly, this, what is the spell? Blood Rage, with a couple levels in it, is essentially gonna be a Doom. Like, it lasts for 9 seconds, well, it lasts for 6, 7, 8, and 9, so if he just gets that on the Doom and then keeps refreshing it in the teamfights, Doom will literally be doomed the entire time, unless he either buys a BKB, or if he is a little feeling a little different and builds a Manta for some reason to break out of those silences, but he has an offlane Doom that's probably going to need to get those support items like a mech, probably phase mech blink, I would imagine his build to be. We'll have to see though. Bloodseeker could really shut down this Doom, as well as the Slark, and look at Wraith King just ripping apart Doom, no armor, bit of HP, looking for another Wraithfire Blast, really, really close, but no one else is responding to this, and Jean will save it, keep that mana and that clarity rolling. And offlane, the Batrider up to level 2, not really doing much better. In fact, doing worse, because he doesn't have Devour. In terms of XP, though, yeah, they're about even. So both offlaners getting pretty shut down. It's not really a surprise. Skywrath is one of the best zoning support heroes in the game in the sort of role where he's got to be the one to fend off the offlaner. The 70 mana Arcane Missile is absurd, or Arcane Bolt. Does quite a bit of damage. Base 60 plus your multiplier, so it's already doing 31 times... multiply by some number, plus 60. I never do math live. Actually, bottom, we've got some trouble. There's going to be the first blood coming out. They dive Doom at the tower. Arrow was used. I'm not really sure if it hit, and if it did, I don't think it was the longest. But we see no mana on Wraithfire Blast, so I can only assume it was. So Doom goes down, gives up that first blood. Got about a whole level before he died, I guess, trying to get up close to that wave for XP, or the wave, rather, at his tower. And then they just dive him to go ahead and kill him. So it's, I don't know, I think it's okay. Devour is unreliable gold, I would assume. Actually, not positive, but if it was reliable gold, that would seem a little broken. So I'm going to assume it's unreliable. But as long as he's devouring on cooldown, he should be okay getting a decent amount of gold. Definitely more than the Batrider. But the difference is Batrider can go into the jungle, and he can farm these creep camps that are all going to be stacked up. So he can definitely catch up quick. You need about level 4, I think, on Batrider these days before you can just run into the jungle. That's what I see a lot of people doing. Just get level 4, 2 in Napalm, 2 in Firefly. Then you can go clear out those stacks. And a quick disconnect reconnect here from the Mirana. Looks like we'll be on our way pretty soon. Middle lane farming. It's pretty even. 14 and 4 on the Tinker, so he's doing pretty well. Not really that contested. And Death Prophet here, Noctis, Naltal, and farming up 11 and 2. And Mirana having internet troubles, it would appear. Alright, looks like we got some people over on the stream. Yeah, so missed the lobby. Couldn't figure out the password. I'm not very smart. So just watching from Dota TV right now. But for game 2, we'll be in. Looks like we're good to go. So far. Oh, pause at 3-2-2. I'm just in spectator chat. I should turn that on. Whatever. I could just jack somebody's camera. Or use directed. Directed's actually pretty good. Alright, Ingman denying people. He's farming 14 and 6. Slark actually doing the best up top. Really not contested at all. I guess neither is bottom. They did get a kill bottom, whereas up top they haven't managed to kill the Batrider. And now he's trying to contest. Using that Radiant offlane advantage, trying to get some of that CS and the XP here. Maybe even kill Daywalker. Does have a Phlegmatic Shield, so you do have to be careful about that. Camp farmed up to level 3. Doom, level 4. Death Prophet will get the Illusion Rune. Not the best rune, but at least it will refill the bottle for her. Skyra's just got the support levels. Mirana, maybe because of some disconnects, actually, she's still level 1, which is not great. She does have Arrow, which is kind of all you need, but obviously you want some more than that. Wraith King, who's got a point in his aura with the pull-throughs, can actually start jungling pretty effectively, just pulling through the camps and maybe chaining all 3 of them. Which isn't the easiest thing to do when you're a melee hero, at least in my experience. But yeah, seems to be doing alright, level 3. Mirana hits almost, still not level 2, 10 XP away. Treads come out here for the Slark up top. Meanwhile, FaZe, gotta go fast, says Ingman, with that FaZe pickup. I honestly gotta disagree with that. I guess the right click is nice, but late game treads are always gonna be more damage with the bonus attack speed. And you're already Bloodseeker, you're already going to be going quite fast. I suppose phasing through things is going to be pretty nice when you're chasing, so I don't know, is that a terrible pickup? I think Treads maybe slightly better. Hard to tell, not really a Bloodseeker player. I don't really want to be a Bloodseeker player. And we'll see if this hero can actually manage to counter out that Slark, because again, that Abaddon, they picked the Bloodseeker after the Abaddon, so they gotta be aware that the Rupture, everything can just be purged off of that Slark. I think Doom is like one of the few abilities that cannot be. Doom and Kunkka's X Mark and a couple other abilities definitely cannot be purged. Rupture should be able to be purged. Again, don't see a lot of Bloodseeker, don't play a lot of Bloodseeker. And he's still farming up pretty nicely. 31-14. Taking a look at Tinker. Yep, is stacking up those ancient camps pretty nicely. Going to get another one there as he looks for the 6-minute rune. Hoping it's top. And it is top. But it's going to be scooped up here by the support Skyrath Mage. Already the fastest hero in the game off the start. Now he is the fastest in the game for sure with that 5-2-2 move speed. Game is kind of slow, actually. I'm surprised that the Tinker and the Wraith King, or excuse me, the Mirana and the Wraith King are trying to do A little bit more. This Wraith King is ready to go core. He's like, nah, I'm done supporting. I'm just going to farm the jungle AFK because they're going to let me. Looks like Batrider finally goes into his jungle. He's up to level 4 looking at Doom. Doom's actually level 5, so doing even a little bit better there. And Regulus trying to take some of this XP. So the jungle definitely being harvested on the side of the Northern Lions. They're using its full potential. They're also using the Ancients, so they're getting a lot out of the map. Or at least they should be, anyways. Looking at Doom, I think he's also gone back into the jungle. He goes boots first with the regen, so it's not really the best. He did find a Satyr, so he's got the Unholy Aura, which is going to give you that 4 HP regen. But he doesn't really have any armor. He's got one. And he doesn't really have any block. Doesn't have that stout shield. So jungling is going to be pretty slow. But you can devour those big creeps. Now he's going to much better spell, I think, for jungling, that attack speed, and for teamfights as well, that attack speed, plus the stun that comes out. And Abaddon will head bottom and look to soak up the XP there. There is a rupture, however. Abaddon's got to be careful. He's only level 4. It's nighttime. I don't think they can see him. They can see about here. See the edge of the vision. So they are aware that Abaddon is there. So actively choosing not to die. Vingman thinks about it. Loses vision through the tree line. But look at this. Jean rotating behind here on the Wraith King. Looking to get that stun off. Stun. Rupture will be a kill. They're actually just going to rupture first. TP is coming in. Daywalker not going to run. Tries to Aphotic but is silenced. Now RNT. Ingman's got to get out of there. People are pretty low, so he is going to be running fast. Slark wants to get him. Let's see if he can. Concussive Blast goes out. Use that phase active. Oh, it's on cooldown. Wouldn't really have mattered anyway. The Pounce will land and get wrecked, says Slark as he brings down Ingman's Bloodseeker. And that is not a trade that's worth it. The other carry gets the kill for that. Bloodseeker only killing a support. Sure, a couple of TPs were used, but much better here for the Slark. He wants to get as many kills as possible. He doesn't want to have to farm creeps in a lane. He wants to farm heroes and snowball out of control. Tinker can farm the creeps in the lane on the other team, and so far he is doing that. But Slark, the man of the hour, rotating behind him, get wrecked. About to wreck Phantom XP in the middle lane. Death Prophet coming forward to throw out this swarm. She's got 404 on her skill build. Ultimate thrown out. Doesn't want to get lasered as he goes in for this. And the blast? Gonna take it away from him. I honestly think maybe give it to the Slark. But also, he's about to run uphill. Not a bad idea to throw the Crypt Swarm and secure the kill. Morana also gonna die there in the bottom lane. I don't know to what. Oh, these guys, just the hit and run. Quick hit and run rolling out. Doom, RNT, and Mamak Club get the kill there. Who actually picks it up? Oh, it was a deny. Wow, nice. Oh, Doom. I'm like, how did they deny? So they Doom up the support. Morana, she gets denied. It wasted a bit of time, but honestly, I think that that's a bigger deal to have wasted the Doom, especially at the end of the day when it gets denied. So nice play by Ingman after getting shut down on his bottom tier 1 dive. Little unfortunate for him. He goes back to farming, though. But the Doom and the Skywrath aren't done. They're going to come back down, and Skywrath's going to look to zone this guy out of the lane completely. But maybe being a little careful with the Arcane Bolt Concussive Blast. Yeah, bit of damage coming out. Up top, though, we got some trouble. Wraith King, his ultimate has been popped off here. He's going to try to go on Daywalker. A Aphotic Shield coming up. Or, you know, deny yourself with Mist Coil. I think either one is going to work. He will be silenced up for a long duration of time. 6 seconds right now, and can they bring him down? They will bring him down. Morana getting that last hit with the leap up to level 4 now. Probably going to put 2 in arrow, 2 in leap, yeah. As a support, you don't really have the items to go ahead and get the Star Swarm as well, because you don't have the mana for the arrow and the Star Swarm. Because if you're a core, you know, you're getting some stat items, maybe drums, and you're getting more levels as well. So your stat gain just really helps facilitate having both of those abilities. But as a support, you generally just completely forget the Star Storm. Maybe you cannot put 4 points in leap, but honestly, I think it's pretty good. The cooldown gets a lot lower, and that attack speed buff really, really helps. And I would even say supports your team in a team fight. Middle lane. I switched over to net worth maybe a little early. Sorry about that. Death Prophet 51-5. Bloodseeker still farming the best, 62-15. And Slark at 56-20. But looking at the net worth, yeah, it's actually pretty much the same. Bloodseeker out in front. Ingman at 4.2. Now Death Prophet overtakes him. It's a tight race for the first spot between the Death Prophet, the Bloodseeker, and the Slark. And there's the first lasso of the game. Northern Lions. CA with that Blink Dagger on the bat. They pull her back. Will get off the Exorcism. Aphotic Shield keeping her alive, but she will go down to the strong right click here of Ingman. Ingman now looking for more. Not level 6. They will bring down the Abaddon as well. Get Wrecked, though, will pick off the Tinker. Pretty good pick off. Ingman has been doomed, and Get Wrecked is actually just going to clean up, I think, here. He's got the Pounce. Will land it, and Ingman is going to go down. Concussive Blast not really needed, but thrown out anyways. And a 2-for-2 trade there. Bloodseeker Tinker going down. Two cores for a core and a support. And maybe they can turn this into a tower with a Tinker being down. Fairly even trade, slightly for Central of Fear, but if they get this tower, massive advantage, especially taking out the mid tower like that. But looks like Slark is saying, no, there's not enough time. Tinker's back, and we should just back off. Skywrath's pretty fast, so he should be okay. And he's going to go back to farming top. He's got 2,300 gold in the bank right now. Wraith King, obviously looking to farm up his Blink Daggers. He's got 1,660 in the bank. And no, I disagree with this completely. He's going for a Midas. Just opting to take it late, I guess. They're going to need to out-carry, but you got a bunch of melee cores against a Slark. Slark often gets underrated, I think, as a late game carry, but his agility steal with some attack speed is utterly ridiculous. Like, he gets a lot of attacks in, and you pretty much have no stats, and he has 300 agility, and he's murdering your faces, especially against all these melees. Tinker, the laser's pretty nice, but again, a Phonic Shield Death Pact, you can get that off essentially right away. And now he's only 300 gold away from going for that Shadow Blade. So that will be the choice here for Get Wrecked. And it's a smart one. We talked about it a little on the draft. About the Slark just shutting down the Tinker anytime he TPs in. And Tinker is, he's doing that now. He's got it going on. He's got the bottle, the soul. And of course the all-important Boots of Travel as he looks to march nothing. You know, a little early there on the creep wave. And marching uphill as well to get those Ancients. So he'll be all over the map, zipping and zapping. But quite as much as Storm Spirit. Now the Rupture goes off. No way to cancel this TP, but can they bring her down? They cannot. She gets back to base. Does not make the mistake of then running in the base and dying. Unfortunately, that does happen sometimes. Get a little antsy. Daywalker going to do the same exact thing, and that's a bit of a problem with this team. But there's the Flame Break coming out from Lion. So he only puts two in Maypalm, then picks up the Flame Break at 7 or 8. Nicely done. Daywalker is... Wow, he actually gets the kill there on the Wraith King as... It is a very, very long cooldown. 5 minutes on that reincarnation, and 20 seconds remaining on it. So he'll have it when he respawns, but kill for a kill there, support for a support. Although this Wraith King arguably a bit of a core hero, because he's building a Midas and farming up pretty hard, so I guess the trade there, again, goes to the Central of Fear. Abaddon's dying a lot, but all of his deaths do seem to be worth it. Maybe not 100% necessary, but I would say definitely... Most of his deaths have been worth it so far. Doom. Is Doom coming along nicely? Doom also went for a Midas. He does have the Buckler, though, so he is going to pick up useful items, which I do enjoy seeing. I like useful items. He's going to get the mech, and I would assume Phase Blink Shivas. It's pretty much the go-to Doom build after the mech. And here they go. Doom out nicely, beautifully done, and the Shadow Blade out. The jump on to Ingman. He will go down, won't be denied. Yellow TPing in. It is Batrider. He does have Lasso available. He's going to look for the Doom. He gets the Doom. Now Regulus here, but Get Wrecked is just destroying people. He's going to take down CA. Doom will eventually fall. Shadowblade here in 5 seconds, but I think Get Wrecked is just going to go back in. He's wrecking people. I like this guy's name. Gene is also going to have a bit of a now. Oh, he pops his wand. He gets the mana. That will pop off his ultimate, however. And now Tinker walking in the march. Get Wrecked! Shadowblading away. And he will get out of there. Gonna try to go on some more, because every time you Shadowblade, your Shadow Dance regen goes up. Well, not every time, because there's a Bloodseeker, but Bloodseeker is dead right now. Radiant's middle tower. Get wrecked. He's gotta be careful. He doesn't want to get wrecked himself. Yeah, he'll just back off. Wise decision. 79-20. His last hits denies. 3-0-4, so involved in 7 of the 9 kills. And that is the 100% correct way to play Slark. Get involved early, and get the kills. It helps that he counters... two of their heroes, I think the Batrider and the Marana. Maybe counters a little too strong of a word for that, but he does do very well against them. I would say he definitely counters the Marana, though. Alright, Daywalker, up to level 8. Nicely done. Looking at the experience, you can see Marana's really far behind. She's only level 5. Wraith King's up to 8. Maybe she's not that far behind. Only level 6, almost level 7. This guy's about a full level ahead, and he's killing her himself. So that's working out pretty nicely for him. He's going to blink away, though. He will lift. Shoots out an arrow. It's going to be off the mark. Daywalker needs to stand in that fire, get as much HP back as possible. Noctis, meanwhile, trying to outrun the outrunnable. But some help is going to come in. Get Rex still has not come back to base to heal, but he will get that off. They don't need to expend the Doom here, I don't think. Yeah, good restraint not using the Doom, as I didn't really need to, and now they can group up and fight with that big Doom ultimate. I think Get Rex needs to go back to base and heal, though, or someone needs to get him some mana boots. Yules is a Dagon? No, this Null Talisman is just from the laning phase. He went phase drums on the Death Prophet. The Staff of Wizardry hopefully is turning into a Yules and not a Dagon. And hero level 12. up on the Slark. 7.6k net worth on him as well. He is leading. Tinker, though, since getting the Boots of Travel, maintaining a pretty secure second place net worth. 6.7k, Death Profit at 6.2, almost 6.3. And everyone back to a little bit more farming as Batrider finds himself a Haste Rune. Get Wrecked, though, on the prowl. This efficiency, though. Look at those power treads. And he's going to find Regulus. You can't leap from that. Just a little bunny hop. And you will go down. Rip.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Alright, Phantom XP. Doing pretty nicely. He's got the Blink Dagger up now, so he can be a lot safer. Blinking into the tree line and spamming out those marches.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Middle tower being pushed in. TP is going to come and defend. That's it. Alright, so 1600 gold here on the Doom, so he looks to be saving up for potentially a Blink Dagger. Wouldn't be against it. He does have the Alpha Wolf Aura right now. There's 1200 on the Bloodseeker. He's actually gone straight into the Blade Mail. But pretty standard build there. There's a lot of damage to go around, especially back towards the Slark. I don't know, though. The Blade Mail armor is also going to be really good against the Death Prophet and returning some of the damage from the Exorcism, because again, that is all physical damage. But I don't know. Blade Mail seems a little underwhelming as an item, I think, on that hero, because you're never really too forced to attack the Bloodseeker. You can actually just TP away. It's not like an axe that would go for it, or even a clockwork that would go for it, where you're called or you're locked in the cogs. And a quick Roshan, they use the Exorcism rank 2 now, level 11 on that Death Prophet, to take down the Rosh quickly, and they will pass the Aegis off to the Slark on Get Wrecked. And I think they might even look to 4-man or 5-man here. Doom is in the bottom lane, though. 2400 gold, and maybe he's saving up for something bigger. I don't know what there is that's bigger than that. There's only a few more items. Single items that are more expensive than a Blink Dagger or like an Ultimate Orb. And that would be the Sacred Relic and the Demon Edge, I think. I don't know. Saving for buyback, I guess. Get Wrecked. I think they see him there in the daytime vision with that tower. Yeah, the Blink Dagger comes out now, just waiting to get to the side shop. So the Blink Dagger's up. And that means, I really like the Blink Dagger on Doom. You can basically choose who you want to Doom as opposed to just like dooming a person. He gets a little aggressive there. And I don't think it's going to matter too much. Ingman will go down to the right click of the Doom. Doom, I don't think we'll get the Doom off, though. Mirana's going to bring him down there. He does. Get Wrecked, though, thrown out. His Pounce needs to get out of here. Does have the Aegis Shadowblading up. Won't even have to use it. Mistcoil goes out. That's going to trigger the ultimate. Not quite the most efficient borrow time that you can get from Abaddon. Skywrath, meanwhile, trying to take out the support. Mirana does, but Tinker's going to get him with the laser. And now Get Wrecked goes back in, almost back to full HP because of his passive as he runs away with the Bloodseeker down. And the laser pounce, that should disjoint the rockets. It does, getting pretty low. Napalm stacking up. Noctis is going to be in some trouble. Will go down. Yes, finally. Gene's going to pick him up there. And Get Wrecked does get away. Actually, didn't use the Aegis yet. Can't cancel the TP with pounce, so looks for a new target. Probably going to go back in. For the Wraith King, just try to force his ultimate out, keep it on a 160 cooldown. Yep, boom. And waste the TP. Oh my gosh, he TP'd, so he didn't have the mana. Oh, wow, that is so unfortunate for Gene. 75 mana OP on that teleport scroll. Doesn't have it for Reincarnate. I guess the good news is Reincarnate's not going to be on cooldown for 160 seconds, so maybe that's not 100% bad, but that's pretty hilarious. Ingman now getting chased down, doomed up, and will drop. Yep, Tinker too busy rearming to try to deny. Doesn't have a lot of mana anyway. Arrow going out off the mark. Tinker gonna have to run back to base. I don't think he's got enough mana to rearm. He does have a soul ring though, so he's fine. The TP back to base, and we'll do just that. And now being chased out here, Skywrath gonna come in with a slow. Oh my gosh, it's gonna slow them both. Mystic Flare a little off the mark, however, Regulus will drop. Now a nice silence up on Batrider reduces that napalm spam, and they should just be able to run out of here. Now someone TPing to the bottom lane. It is going to be Tinker in a bit of trouble, I think. Not going to be able to get into the tree line now. Get Wrecked is going to alt up. Tinker trying to rearm that blink, and does, because that is a hero. Like, how dumb is that? Hard to kind of angle this pounce, and Tinker will get away. Tower goes down. Not last hit by anybody, but not denied either. So still a win there for Central of Fear. Putting a lot of pressure on that Tinker. So many viewers over here on this Twitch channel. Alright, the blink is up. Another 2,400 gold on the Doom already. Every time you look over at this guy, he's got 2,400 gold. Plate mail coming out? Maybe the Mystic Staff first? I, again, would expect the Shivas coming out. Wouldn't mind him finishing Phase either, or even Treads. Phase does seem to be the more often chose item, just to rotate around a little faster. Maybe that's why Bloodseeker gets it too. Although chasing at max move speed and being able to ignore unit collision is going to be pretty good on Bloodseeker. Yeah, Wreck though, he goes for Treads like a man. Looking for some people. I'm really worried this guy never has any mana. Like, you're kind of pushing the limits. And remember, Reincarnate is still up here for Gene. And yeah, Dire Ward up. Actually, only one ward apiece for each team. Oh no, here we go. One in the lane as well. That protects the jungle a little bit and protects whoever's farming up in this top lane. Because you do still have your safe lane tower up, and when you do have the tower up, I think this ward, even when you don't, this ward is still pretty good at all points in the game. A lot of people will run through there expecting it not to be warded and try to gank you in the jungle. A lot of times people will also smoke there, so then it doesn't really matter. Alright, it runs out now. We'll see if they go to refresh it. Mamak does have another ward, and I think that's exactly what he's going to do. Also helps against Tinker. You see Tinker TP in and then wait behind a creep wave for a little while. So lane wards go a long way, I think, against Tinker, and are pretty good in general, especially in certain games. And does he refresh it? No, still holding that Observer ward. Alright, let's take a look at the net worth again. Stark's still up out at front. Aegis is going to be reclaimed here in a minute, so at least he'll finally have mana again. He's one level ahead of the Tinker. He's level 16, the highest in the game. Doom 14, Death Prophet 13. Net worth, he's in front, 11.2k. Tinker at 10.4. Doom in that offlane at 10.1. So he's about 5,000 gold ahead of the offlane opponent, which is the Batrider. Of course, Batrider doesn't have Devour, he doesn't have the Midas, but it just goes to show you the power of the Doom. He gets pretty shut down in the lane, even gives up a kill to the Bloodseeker, but doing really well so far. And I hear a pounce, where is it? Get wrecked! Wrecking people once more! Dude, I wanted to get a Diffusal. Take all that mana from Gene, because Gene will have Reincarnate right now, get silenced up. Gonna start to respawn. Tinker coming in, trying to remedy this. There's a nice Mystic Flare. Gene gets blown up immediately, and I think the Blink was used there, but maybe could have Blink Doomed the Tinker and looked to push down this Tier 2 tower without having to deal with the March. But they don't really care too much. At this point, you could have pushed down the Tier 3 tower, maybe, if you doomed that Tinker. They pop the Exorcism, and they're just gonna back. And Mamak going up top as well. Batrider is here. I don't think the Skywrath is gonna be enough to bring him down, but they're gonna start pushing this lane and look to take out these Tier 2 towers. They do find him. The Concussive Shot will land. He's gonna start the TP. The Yule Scepter mistakes are made! And now he's in a bit of trouble. He does still have that Firefly available. The Silence was not quick enough. He's running north, though. I think that's a bit of a mistake. I mean, it's in his name. But I think running down this tree line would have been maybe a little bit better. Get closer to maybe the Mirana. Maybe an arrow saves you. And get wrecked. Still just bringing people down. Kills that other one roll. That Bloodseeker in the middle lane. He's got a Scatty up. An Eye of Scatty completed. And still 1,600 gold in the bank. Wow. Guy's farming up a storm. Again, sights on objectives. They're looking for the Tier 2 tower. Roshan respawning in anywhere from 1 to 4 minutes. Arrow has not landed. There's been a couple good arrows this game, but a lot... When COF has been deathballing, there haven't really been too many arrows that have hit anybody. Just dodging them, especially in the daytime. Gene gonna get picked off. Get Rex starting to break the high ground right now. He doesn't have a gem, doesn't want to lose this. And it didn't look like she was in biz, actually. Yeah, she did throw out her ultimate, but the gem up here on the Slark, probably one of the better items you can buy on Slark. You do have to play maybe a little more reserved once you get the gem, so as to not just lose it immediately. But it's also not terrible if you give it up against the Slark. Sure, it sucks for your team, you can't ward as effectively, and you're likely to lose map control, but still, when you ult, they can't see you with the Gem of True Sight anyways. Oh, he actually Daywalker bought it on the Abaddon, so supporting hard over there on that hero. Dagon up on the Tinker, only level 1 though. He does also have a Ghost Scepter. And rotating over to the middle lane, looking to push that out, and they're going to have their sights on this bottom Tier 2 tower, and then probably a Roche, then smoke to pick off a Tinker, breach the high ground. I think that's the ideal strat here. Okay, well, who am I kidding? They don't need to smoke to pick off the Tinker. Slark can just go wait in the lane and kill Tinker. I mean, we actually saw him struggle with that a little bit, because you can rearm your broken Blink Dagger and get away, and Phantom's XP did do that earlier down in this region. But we'll have to see. Slark definitely can't pick off the Tinker, and also a little bit harder because of this Ghost Scepter. Slark should get a Daggon. He actually should get a Daggon. That would be pretty good. Anytime he Ghost Scepters, just kill him immediately. Because he's only going to do it when he gets low, right? Trying to push it to the last second. But we see Wraith King getting picked off there. Probably will die again. I don't know if they're going to want to fight up in this march. Now Pouncing can't drag anywhere because he's stuck on a leash. The Batrider. They actually will bring down the Doom. And nicely down there on the Death Pack. Going to go ahead and leap away from that. Going to take an arrow to the face. Yeah, arrow to the backside rather. Laser as well to the backside. And he's going to die. That's going to give up the gem. Mirana will scoop it up. So Regulus has that. But a push coming in the bottom lane here from the other three. And maybe a bit of miscommunication, or they're just feeling a little too good about themselves here, as they only put three heroes, or two heroes on the top lane, three in the bottom. They split up. Doom and Slark go a little too deep and give up their lives for it. Bottom lane, though, another pickoff. They kill the Bloodseeker. Phantom XP is here, though, and he's want to kill an Oculus. I think there could have been a quick rearm blink Daggon. Maybe worried about a Mystic Flare, but that is on cooldown. That does not destroy it. Doublethinker knows what's up. He thinks it could have broken high ground. I'm assuming, well, that's 2 minute delay, still on stream, but 4 minute from in-game, as I'm not in the lobby. But yeah, I think if they killed that Tinker, they probably could have went up to the high ground. I'm assuming that's what he's talking about. 13-23, leading by 10 kills right now, Central of Fear, but the game, definitely going to be prolonged. You're playing against the Tinker. That Wraith King, he really does get going around 30-40 minutes when he's a core, so probably closer to the 40 benchmark. As of right now, he's got Treads, Drums, Midas. Oh no, he's actually going for a Blade Mail to fight against that Death Prophet, because you see the Chainmail in the inventory. Yep, Blade Mail gets completed. Oh, I'm leaning far away from my mic. Had to have a little stretch. Prepping for that long game. 28 minutes in. Net worth, now the Tinker leads, first time since the really early game, if ever. Tinker's up front, 14.2k, and it's still going to be the Dire ahead in gold overall, by a lot, actually. 12,000 gold ahead, 12,000 XP ahead, but they're bringing it back. It was up to about 14, and now it's coming back down towards even 10, potentially. But a lot of that is just on this Tinker, so if Tinker dies, he's going to be in a little bit of trouble. Actually, Get Wrecked should maybe get a Blink Dagger. The Daggon, although I don't think it would be terrible, was kind of trolly. But Blink would be really good, I think. Although, he's kind of that one roll, so maybe you do need just that right-click damage. Because this game will inevitably go late, and you're going to want to be able to fight up against that Wraith King. The Mirana, the Tinker, the Bloodseeker, everyone else, basically. Mirana's, what, coming along? Not really. Urn and Boots. She did pick up the gem, and she'll continue to hold it, so that's another pretty big priority kill for Central Fear. They want to get that gem back. Looking at the map now, there's no Dire Wards. There are three very defensive wards from the Radiant here in this mid lane and mid lane river area. That one's about to run out, but you get the idea. They're really trying to protect this middle lane. They don't want to get picked off and then lose a Rax there, because they are pretty vulnerable mid and top. Bottom, the Tier 2 still stands, so Central of Fear is still going to have to go through that. And there it is, the Blink Shiva's mech. No phase, though. Goes for the minus. Blink Shiva's mech. Assuming another 100 gold, maybe another 1,000 gold, so as to save for the buyback, or maybe a bit more than 1,000. Actually, we can look. He's got it available now, so he can't look. Yeah, he probably wants to go boots to travel. That's got to be why he never upgraded his boots. The only thing I can think of. Alright, let's see. Smoke up here. This is really nice. They can smoke up, and then they can Moonlight Shadow in the teamfight, and there's no gem up on Central of Fear anymore, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Are there sentries, though? I don't think there are. Get Wrecked is going to be the target. He's going to try to Dark Pack that. The Doom goes off onto Ingwen. Maybe should have Doomed the Tinker. The Wraith King is dead. Can they kill the Mirana as well? She might just die to neutrals here. No, she will die. Slark picks her up. Now, Tinker running away on the backside of the fight into enemy territory, but will be okay. Northern Lions also going to TP. Now, Exorcism using that TP fight. Abaddon going to try to heal up the Death Prophet, and they can push down this Tier 2 bottom tower. All outer towers then taken off the map here at 31 minutes against a Tinker, while only losing one of their own in the safe lane, or the off lane, excuse me. So that Dire offlane Tier 1 falls. All the outer towers for the Northern Lions are down. So I think so far, really, really well played game by the Central of Fear. but high ground breaking is going to be a bit of a different story. If they're going to pull back into Doom here, and he will drop. Maybe they go back exorcism in 50 seconds. I say in 50 seconds, they either smoke off, try to kill somebody, or Slark tries to kill the Tinker in a lane, and then they go for the Roche. That is pretty much their next objective right now, as they look to break into the high ground. Looking at all the items this game, as we will just highlight the Slark real quick while we do that. We've got the Blade Mail finish up on the Bloodseeker, Blade Mail coming out on the Wraith King, Ethblade Dagon, Blink up on Phantom, Blink Dagger, as well as a Ghost Scepter up on the Bat Rider, so he's tired of being killed, but he does not have a Four Staff, which is a fairly big deal, and Boots of Travel on him as well, and Urn on the support Mirana, very far behind. Basher comes out, as well as a Skadi and a Lothar's, plus another Gem of True Sight. Actually, I think they got it back from the Mirana here for Get Wrecked. So we've got a Blink Shiva's Mech, the best Doom build ever, and I'm glad Doom built it, because he has it this game. And then we've got a Yule Scepter again, just a defensive item to go ahead and stay alive against the Tinker Burst by some time. Same thing goes for Noctis with his Yule's pickup. It's also probably the best item you can get on Death Prophet. She goes for a Lincoln's. And we've got a Vlad's up, as well as an Urn on the side of the Central of Fear. So in terms of the items, I would definitely say Central of Fear is very far ahead. And obviously, we can see that they're 15,000 gold ahead. So that's like three really big items. Most of them are on Slark. With that Skadi and the Skull Basher, plus how much gold does he have? He's almost to the Abyssal Blade, and that's a really big pickup. Then he can kill Tinker no matter what. Batrider trying to get some split push in. He does buy the Boots of Travel. Both teams opting toward this high ground here. We'll see if anyone has the sense to deward it. If anyone, I think it's going to be the gem. And Slark will know when his passive turns off that it's warded. And another sort of good intersection at this point of the game, warded up here from the Dire. He's looking around, I think, at the jungle to see if they have any vision. Checking the T here, as well as the big part of the Radiant Jungle, but not finding anything. Oh, turns off for a second. That's just because he took damage. Everyone grouped up in the mid lane, has 5 on the Northern Lions. They're too scared to get picked off. Even Tinker's here, so you know that the threat is real. And the Aegis, they did do that Rosh, as I said. Daywalker, they don't have the burst, so his ultimate will go off. They got an Outbreak him down. He wants to cast a Mist Coil, he will. Now he's back to about full HP. Jean gonna get silenced up, will pop his own Blade Mail. They can't kill him during that. March, actually Doom goes out on Regulus the March though, going over quite a bit of people. Jean's still up here, and with a stun, RNT in some trouble, will live. Good job, Abaddon. Like a boss, they lose two. Jean, ultimate has been popped. Doom also was used. The stun again goes out. Jean just running through that Mystic Flare. Doesn't have a care in the world, but Jean's gonna fall there, get wrecked. Puts him on a leash. Makes him sit. Now we've got the Batrider in maybe a bit of trouble. Can potentially get a kill. No. Just gonna run away, stay in XP range. Nicely done. And there we go. Now 2-1 is the kill ratio. Okay, it says get wrecked in all chat. 28-14, 34 minutes in. Phantom will get a kill though. Gets the sky with the rockets across the river. Now they're looking for him. The Abyssal Blade not yet purchased. About 90 gold short there. Now leashed up, can't cancel the TP because he can't attack, so we can't even get a bash because of the Ghost Scepter. Shots from the Twitch chat being fired here. He's in some trouble now. Can he get that bash? No, silence up. Phantom just gonna TP. There's the Yule Scepter. He's gonna have to have another rearm session. But he will get bashed up, and that's gonna be Tinker taking a fall there in the tree line. Now, gonna go a kill top as well, just leaping straight over the hill, looking for more. It's gonna force Ingman to just run away. And the Aegis reclaimed in 3 minutes. Abyssal Blade has been purchased. That's where he was going to purchase. Still way out in front of the net worth. Now Tinker has fallen back. 17.6k on the Slark, 16.6 on the Doom, and the High Ground Breach comes at a 15,000 and gold and XP advantage here. Aegis again, still up for a couple minutes. Look to bring down the Tier 3 tower, but Tinker has bought back. They forced it out of him. And looking at all the buybacks for the teams, we've got Doom and Death Prophet with buybacks, so even if they get wiped here, they're not in too much danger of losing anything. But Northern Lions, if they sustain heavy losses right now, up against the ropes with no buybacks, game's pretty much over. Alright, get wrecked. Gonna look for them. Oh my gosh, they're gonna run straight into them. Silence goes out onto Jean. His ultimate's still on cooldown, actually, if they can bring him down. Again, Doom, Twitch chat pointed it out, terrified of Rupture, just keeps dooming that Bloodseeker over and over again. Phantom goes down. That was his buy, his death back, whatever you call it, the die back. That rhymes with buy. And that's the GG call. Report DP. GG. 36 minutes in. 32-15. About a 16,000 golden XP advantage here in game number one. Central of Fear, take it away. So Slark basically did really well that game. I enjoyed it. Played like a boss. I had too much else to say. It's just the Batrider got shut off on the offlane. So did Doom. But Doom's got Devour. He went back into the jungle. Batrider got his blink up pretty early, but after a while, can't really blink initiate against the Slark. Slark was a good pickup against the Bat and the Morana, so I really like that. And they just ran away with the game, always being able to pick people off. And of course, after they pick people off, they could push really fast because they've got the Death Prophet Exorcism. Doom's got the really good auras that he's bringing with the team. Abaddon had some clutch plays keeping his teammates alive. And maybe if those team fights went a little different, if Abaddon wasn't the hero here, maybe Northern Lions could have got back into this game because they maybe had the ultra late. I still think Central Fear had the ultra late and probably the better draft, but either way, we'll get into game two. I'll be in lobby for that one, and we'll be back in a moment here on Join Dota Community. Peace.